Good day traders, this is Glenn from Practical Pips. Welcome to your update for the 13th of January 2015. We're going to be looking at four pairs today. We may also answer some questions on a couple of other trades, but the main ones we want to look at are these. So to kick it off, the New Zealand CAD. We were looking at this trade as a potential buy last week. We decided not to take it. For those of you who missed our previous videos, why were we looking at buying it? Well, we saw this pin bar appear a couple of weeks ago and how price broke through it last week and closed so high, which is a really, really bullish sign, obviously taking out a lot of stops on the way. Definitely a good trade. Why we didn't take it, the risk-reward ratio was just unfortunate. So the first target is kind of here where I've drawn this line at 92, almost 93. If we'd just broken the top of this pin bar and closed somewhere around here, we would have had almost 130 pips to work with, but the pair just went really too far, and we're not in the habit of chasing trades. It's definitely something that can get you burnt, as we do expect a bit of a retrace, especially down to sort of these levels here on the week. So that's just for anyone who was watching that pair with us. The second pair I wanted to have a look at is a trade that we actually sent out today. So our subscribers, the EURAUD, looking at it on a weekly time frame, we've seen several very bearish weeks in a row. We're looking at definitely selling on this break. We've seen a retest. We've seen price sort of wick up into this 146 area. A longer wick would have been nice, but we're quite happy to sell from below these lows, targeting 138.35, and then there is a second target a little bit further, but definitely a good looking trade, one that we're very happy with. Another pair that we thought we'd highlight, a very interesting classical formation, would be the head and shoulders. This is the USD Singapore yen on a 4-hour chart. You can see this first shoulder, head with a higher high, second shoulder. This top line here represents what we would call the neckline, and traditionally the way to trade these is once price closes below the neckline, it's going to go, and you'd expect it to go down to this next level, 132.45, and even potentially 132 even. So definitely one that we're going to be watching. Bit of weakness in the dollar at the moment that would be nice to take advantage of in the short term. Finally, the pound Aussie, we had a couple of questions on that. So we've seen a couple of weeks of downward movement, very bearish movement. Yesterday we spiked back up into this zone, very important zone, 186.25. You can see a resistance, blasted through, came up, resistance. Are we going to see a bounce off this level and sell, or are we going to see some sort of consolidation and go up? Either way, very nice trade. If it becomes a buy trade, we've got a zone of over 500 pips to work with, and if we see a sell signal, we're looking at almost about the same. So a great one to watch, and we will update you further. Have a good day.